What do we need to think about these private revelations that claim to have the name of certain guardian angels? The name of certain angels of heaven. Then first of all it is necessary to know that in the public revelation, that is to say the Holy Scripture, there are a number of angels and even demons, which receive a name. Among the angels, we can count mainly three archangels. That is to say, angels who announce things, who do grandiose things, and who are nevertheless among the hierarchies closest to us, therefore lower angelic hierarchies. We know Michael, which means in Hebrew who is like God. It is the angel who, it seems, at the time of the fall of the demons, says to them, "You claim to revolt for the honor of God, but who is like God, so that you are like that?" Second, we know Raphael, namely God heals. It is the angel who heals, especially Tobias, in the book of Tobias in the Bible. And finally we know Gabriel, God announces, who made Mary's announcement for the incarnation of the Word of God. It should be noted that these angels, these three archangels, have a name related to their mission, in relation to us. To know how to heal, to announce something, and then to fight against the demons. From the Middle Ages, popular devotion began to have hundreds of revelations of names of angels, like that. To the point that some even said to each person, "This is the name of your guardian angel." They were names in Latin very often. So that at a given moment, in the face of the sometimes exaggerated things, but it was the popular devotion, the church put the high there to it, and forbid that one thus gives names. So this decision, pastoral of the time obviously, is no longer relevant. And the thing comes back. It means that people receive revelations, inner intuitions, and tell others, "This is the name of your guardian angel." So what you need to know about this is that first of all the real name, the name of the angels, corresponds to their essence. It means their deep nature. But it turns out that angels have no body, and that their minds are unique. So that, says Saint Thomas Aquinas, every angel is like an entire species, alive on its own. So that to know the name of a particular angel, as it is, in this land it is impossible. It means that in the other world, when our mind will see their spirit, then we will know their name that corresponds to their nature. Moreover, I must add, that it is exactly the same for the people, the saints who are in heaven like the Virgin Mary. For example, in the appearance of Amsterdam, the Virgin appears as the one who used to be called Mary. It does not mean that we cannot call it Mary. She is given her name, which she had on earth. But her name, the new name that God gave her, when she entered the beatific vision. No one knows him except God, and those who are with her in heaven. Since it corresponds to the infinite purity of his soul. So it's his end quote, essence end quote, we could say, in the same way as for angels. Result, the name of the angels, it is related to the intimacy they have with God, and it is something that is them, quite, personal. And yet we see it in the Bible, as I said, they sometimes give their names, and it should be noted that they are names, which are related to their missions. Well, now, when it happens that an angel's name is revealed, in general it's not his personal name, unique, when we'll see them at the time of our death, but it's rather the name of the particular mission they have on us, according to what our vocation is. Or according to the defect, which must correct in us. For example, a friend who is a priest, told me that a person had communicated to him, that the name of his guardian angel was Angelo, Angelo, which means the envoy, and indeed this priest was sent in mission among the nations, to preach Christ. A woman told me another time, that the angel that was revealed to her as her guardian angel, was called Lucas, in Latin, which means light. So this woman was very contemplative, and probably it had something to do with her vocation, the contemplation of the Trinity. Lucas, which must not be confused with Lucifer. Lucifer, being first the name of Christ in the Bible, in three particular places. Especially in the Apocalypse, it is the morning star, the one that announces the face of God directly, since the humanity of Christ announces the divinity of this same Christ, whom we will see at the hour of death. But it is a name grabbed later by the rebellious angel, Lucifer, who presents himself as the one who brings light to the world, but another form of light. So to conclude, I would say that angels can sometimes reveal their names, but it is rather their temporary missions, temporary that they have on us, that they reveal then. When their names, in the true sense of the word, it will be revealed to us at the time of our death. That being said, we must not practice this devotion with excess, as was the case in the Middle Ages, but simply as something, which can sometimes, when it is given to us, by someone who is close to God, a word of knowledge, a particular charisma, to take it as a little wink from the sky, which indicates something, in relation to our soul, that the guardian angel develops or corrects.